Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the Originator ID BGP attribute. Now, iBGP requires a full mesh of iBGP peerings within an AS. Along with that requirement, the iBGP split horizon rule is also enforced in order to prevent routing loops. Route reflectors are a mechanism used to bypass the requirement of the full mesh of peerings, vastly improving the scalability of an AS. However, when employing route reflectors, we are also bypassing that all-important split horizon rule. For this reason, when we deploy route reflectors, we need to introduce another mechanism that will prevent routing loops within an AS. That's why route reflectors use two particular pieces of information to prevent routing loops. And these are the originator ID and the cluster list. In this video, we'll be talking about the originator ID, and I'll leave the cluster list attribute for an upcoming video. The originator ID is actually a BGP attribute. It's an attribute that is only used in the context of route reflectors. If you haven't done so already, first take a look at two of my previous videos, one on route reflectors and another on the basic route reflector configuration on Cisco IOS routers before you go on. You'll find links to those videos in the description below. Taking a look at those videos will definitely make this video much more understandable. Now, the originator ID is a BGP attribute, as I mentioned, but it's not involved in the BGP best path selection algorithm. As a BGP attribute, it appears as a value of a field that exists within the BGP updates that are exchanged between BGP routers. And as we will see, the originator ID is present only in BGP updates sent by route reflectors. In order to understand what this attribute actually does, let's take a look at a practical example. Here we have four client routers and a single route reflector. Now remember, within an AS, all routers should be able to reach all other routers using an IGP, and this is a prerequisite of ensuring that BGP will function correctly within the AS. So here we have client router C1, which has a router ID of 1.1.1.1, and it has a network that's directly connected. That's the 20.20.20.0/24 network. Now, C1 will advertise this network to the route reflector here. When it advertises the network, it will also include its own router ID of 1.1.1.1 as part of that BGP update, as is to be expected with any other BGP peering. Now, the route reflector, in turn, will advertise this network to its iBGP neighbors, because that's what a route reflector does. For example, the BGP updates that are sent to this client router C2 will include the originator ID attribute as well as the cluster list, which we'll talk about in another video. That originator ID attribute will contain the router ID of the originating router. In this case, the information about the 20.20.20.0/24 network was originally generated by C1, and the originator ID that we see is thus set to C1's router ID, which is 1.1.1.1. Now, why is this important? Well, because when a route reflector advertises a network it receives from a client, it will advertise it to both client routers and non-client routers. It'll even send it to the client router from which it originally received it. So C1 will receive this BGP update. Why? Because by definition, route reflectors do not obey the split horizon rule. So if C1 receives an update from the route reflector for the 20.20.20.0/24 network with an originator ID attribute equal to its own router ID, it will simply ignore the update, thus avoiding a routing loop. Now, here are some details to keep in mind about how this originator ID operates. First of all, the originator ID is a BGP attribute, as we've said, and it's sent only by the route reflector itself. So it is only in BGP updates sent by the route reflector that we will find originator IDs. Client routers and non-client routers never include the originator ID attribute in their updates. Secondly, not all updates from a route reflector contain an originator ID. Only those routes reflected from a client router will contain an originator ID. So for example, C1 here is a client router, and it sends an update to the route reflector containing the 20.20.20.0/24 network. The route reflector will reflect that route to both client and non-client routers, and it'll send the originator ID attribute along with it. R2 here is a non-client IBGP peer with the route reflector, and it advertises the 30.30.30.0/24 network to the RR. The route reflector, according to its rules of reflection, will reflect that route only to clients, but it will not include an originator ID in that update because it came from a non-client. Now, why is this? Because since R2 is a non-client, the split horizon rule will take care of preventing routing loops for networks advertised. Now, one may ask, why would the route reflector include the originator ID in updates it sends to non-clients? By definition, only client router IDs appear in the originator ID field of BGP updates. So theoretically, a non-client will never see its own router ID in the originator ID field. Why must the originator ID be conveyed to non-clients as well then? Well, if we have only one route reflector, then yes, that is the case. But if we have two or more route reflectors, it becomes necessary to include those originator IDs in updates to non-clients. To see that, let's take a look at this next example. Here we have two route reflectors, RR1 and RR2. Now C1 is a client of RR1, and C2 here is a non-client neighbor of RR1 and a client neighbor of RR2. Now, when we have two or more route reflectors, the rule is that all route reflectors in the AS must have full mesh IBGP peerings configured between them. And also, route reflectors will reflect all of their routes to other route reflectors within the AS. Now, keeping all that in mind, let's say that C2 here advertises the 30.30.30.0/24 route to its own route reflector of RR2. RR2 adds the originator ID of C2, which is 2.2.2.2, and it advertises this route to its clients, including C2. Of course, C2 will see its own originator ID and it will simply ignore the route. RR2, however, will also send the update to its fellow route reflector RR1, and when it does so, it sends the originator ID of 2.2.2.2 as well. RR1 in turn will send this update to both its client and non-client IBGP neighbors. And as you can see here, C2 is one of its non-client neighbors. So when C2 receives this update, it will see its own router ID in the originator ID field, and it will not process that particular route of the update. Now keep in mind that when a route reflector reflects a route to its own clients, it includes the original originator ID in the update. The originator ID is thus preserved throughout the entire route propagation process in an IBGP route reflector environment. So this is why the originator ID is sent by the route reflector to both clients and non-client neighbors. So that's the purpose of the originator ID BGP attribute, how it works, and why it's necessary to have it in route reflector environments due to the absence of the IBGP split horizon rule. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this video has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.